Hello everyone. So the first slide which you saw was of a masala chai or a masala tea. It was about the elements which are required for a good masala chai. So why did I show you the masala chai or the ingredients required for a masala chai? Well, no, I've not changed my area of specialization. It is actually I was showing you the elements required for a successful or a good masala chai, because I wanted to relate it to the next chapter which we will be doing, which is elements of yield management or elements of revenue management. Now there are mainly 5 elements of yield management or revenue management, namely group room sales, transient room sales, food and beverage activity, local and area wide activities, and special events. The first one, group room sales, I hope you must be knowing, if 15 or more persons together come for a booking or for a stay in the hotel, it's considered as a group booking or a group room sale in the hotel. So now groups form a major part of the business which is earned in the hotel, major for part of the revenue which is earned by the hotels. And also they are very important because hotels are confirmed the number of rooms or are confirmed about the revenue which will be earned from the groups quite a long time before they actually come for the stay. Because groups normally book their rooms at least 3 months, 2 to 3 months before their stay. It can even go back up to say 1 year or more. So it's very important. They are very important for the hotels. But of course, we have to consider many factors which go along with the group room sales or the group room bookings. The first one is we have to consider the group booking data, as in we have to consider the number of rooms which they book and which they actually take when they come for the stay, if there is any discrepancy. Normally if it is an old group or a group which has already arrived before, which has a history with the hotel, then we should check if they normally delete their or they normally cancel a number of rooms or a particular number of rooms. So hotels, what they do, especially in high demand seasons, they before the groups come, on their own previous history of the groups, they delete a number of bookings from the group booking, which is called a wash factor. Wash factor is when the hotels delete the unnecessary number of rooms which have been booked by the groups, maybe for their own safety, on the basis of the previous history record of the groups. Now this is important so that there is no loss of revenue because of those unnecessary number of rooms which have been booked by the groups. We also have to consider the anticipated group business which the hotel might consider. As for example, there are many events, many companies which have particular policies about where they hold their events. Like for example IPL, they have fixed stadiums or fixed areas or fixed cities wherein they have their matches. So the hotels who have tie-ups with the companies which hold the IPL, they have an idea about when the events will be held, and therefore they have an idea about the number of rooms which might be booked by the companies for the stay of the people involved in the event. So anticipated group business is very important because it gives an idea to the hotel about the groups which might come in the specific time periods. Next is we also have to consider the group booking lead time. Group booking lead time is the time between the booking and the stay, arrival of the groups. So the time between the booking and the arrival is called the lead time. So group booking lead time is also very important, because if it is too far from the time of arrival, then the hotels have to make sure that the group is actually coming, and also have to make sure that they get the payments in between the time of the booking and the arrival, so that there are lesser chances of cancellation and therefore lesser chances of loss of revenue. Next is we also have to consider the displacement of transient business. Displacement is acceptance of group business instead of transient business. Now there is of course a certain loss of revenue, especially in high demand seasons, when the hotels sell rooms to groups instead of transient guests, because of course transient guests will pay more than a group booking, as groups always have a certain amount of discount applied to their rates, whereas transient guests have lesser discounts or maybe no discounts. So that is called displacement. So that has to be considered in case of high demand seasons, if the groups can be given the booking or not. The next element of a successful revenue management is transient room sales. Now transient room sales is very important, because they normally do not have discounts, or they have lesser discounts as compared to groups. Now they're very important because they come all through the year, they might come anytime, and they have lesser lead times. You have walk-ins also who come and who might be considered as transient rooms, room guests. Now transient room guests are mostly targeted during the low demand seasons, and they are also given packages or special rates for or upgrades, maybe deluxe rooms at standard rates, so that they can be attracted and a room can be sold instead of just being left vacant. So that is very important, especially in the low demand seasons. The next element of a successful revenue management or a yield management is food and beverage activity. Now when a food and beverage activity normally over here is the reference given to the banquets or group bookings for the food and beverage. Now if there is a booking for a marriage or a booking for an anniversary celebration, then they might want a banquet as well as a certain number of guest rooms also. So always, whenever there are rooms which are being booked, food and beverage or other non-revenue centers, non-room revenue centers are also considered, so that they can discuss and they can also contribute with the sales or the revenue of the hotel. So food and beverage activity is very important, because if there is a group which requires both food and beverage facility, for example banquets and also guest rooms, then it is always very important to sell a room to a group which requires both the food and beverage and rooms, rather than a group which requires only the rooms. So because it brings in more revenue for the hotel, so always there is a scope for more revenue, and the revenue manager should always consider the groups which require food and beverage activities or food and beverage facilities also. The next element of yield management is local and area wide activities. Local and area wide activities are the activities which take place in the city, in and around the city. It can be a cricket match, it can be a festival, it can be a religious ceremony, it can be any other activity which is taking place in and around the city, which might affect the sale of rooms. So it has to be considered so that the yield management team can plan their room sales accordingly. The last element of a successful revenue management or an yield management is special events. Special events, now it can be inside the hotel or outside the hotel or around the hotel. Now special events, again, as I said, can be a Christmas party or a New Year party or any other special celebrations or a musical night. So any other events, any special events which are taking place inside the hotel or around the hotel are also a very important factor in a room sales of the hotel. So I hope you enjoyed the chapter. Thank you so much. See you in the next class. Hello everybody, so I'm back with a new chapter of the same unit, yield management. The name of the chapter is potential high and low demand tactics. Now, what is a high demand and what is a low demand and what are tactics? Now, high demand season is when the demand for the rooms, hotel rooms, is high, on the higher end. There's a lot of demand for the hotel rooms and so the room sales is higher. And low demand is when the room sales is lower and there is a less demand of the rooms. For example, if it is a hill station, the high demand season would be the summers, because people like to enjoy their summers in a cool place. So a resort in hill station would be maybe having a full occupancy or close to full occupancy in the summers, whereas having a low demand in the winters. Now, what are tactics? Tactics are the techniques or the methods which are used during the high demand or the low demand so that there is higher revenue in the hotel. So we will be discussing the techniques or the tactics which are used in the high demand season first, and then we will be going on to the low demand tactics which are used in the hotel. So the first high demand tactic which is used by the hotel is close or restrict discounts. Now, as we all know that there are many discounts which are offered to guests, and there are many discount categories which are there in the hotel. For example, there are airline rates, there are travel agency rates, there are group rates. So there are many discounts which are given for different categories of guests. But during high demand seasons, the hotels try to close or they try to restrict the discounts or limit the discounts to as low as possible so that there is less loss of revenue in the hotel. The second one is applying the minimum length of stay restriction in the hotel. Now, what is minimum length of stay? Minimum length of stay means when the guest is required to book at least for 2 to 3 days or more in the high demand season instead of just one day. So if there are two guests, one guest wanting a room for a single day and another guest who is wanting a room for 3 days, so always during a high demand season, a guest who is asking for a 3-day reservation is considered rather than a guest who is asking for a reservation of 1 day. So applying minimum length of stay restrictions especially in high demand, is guaranteeing the hotel a revenue for more number of days. Next one is reduce group bookings. Now, group bookings are a source of revenue to the hotels all through the year, and they also give a volume business to the hotel. But as we all know, they have a good amount of discount which is given to them as per the contracts which are drawn with the hotel. So it is always advisable to reduce or restrict the group bookings, especially during the high demand season. Next one is reduce or eliminate the 6 p.m. holds. I hope you remember the non-guaranteed reservations, wherein if a guest has a non-guaranteed reservation, they might come within the cancellation hour for the room, and their room is kept ready for them till the cancellation hour, which is normally 4 to 6 p.m. in the evening. But during the high demand season, the 6 p.m. holds or the cancellation hour holds are generally reduced or not taken into consideration. Next one is tightening the guarantee or the cancellation policies. Now, the guaranteed reservations, I hope you all know that during the guaranteed reservation, a guest guarantees minimum 1 day's room rate to the hotel at the time of reservation, even if he does not turn up for the stay. So, the tightening of the guaranteed reservations means if a guest having a guaranteed reservation wants to cancel, then he might have to cancel. There should be a minimum number of days before which he has to cancel. Otherwise, the guaranteed amount will not be refunded or returned to the guest. This is done specially in the high demand season so that there is a least chance of loss of revenue to the hotel. Next is having consistent rates with the competitors or the hotels which are nearby or in the same city. So consistent rates means rates which are not either too high nor too low than the competitor hotels which are there in the same city or in the same area. The next high demand tactic which the hotels use is to raise the prices for the packages. Packages are when the hotels combine two or more products of the hotel and formulate a rate for the products combined together. So it might be rooms with meals or any other activities in the hotel, or the use of any non-room revenue centers, etc. So normally during high demand seasons, the hotels consider raising rates for the packages. The next would be applying full prices to suites and executive rooms. Full prices means without any discounts, the standard rates which are applicable. Now, especially during high demand seasons, since there are lesser number of suites and executive rooms in the hotels, so it is always advisable to sell them at full rates so that there is a maximum chance of higher revenue. The next high demand tactic is reserving close to arrival dates. Now, we should not close the reservations just maybe before a week or so, and keep the reservations open maybe closer to the arrival dates so that there is maximum chances of reservations and maximum chances therefore of the sale of rooms. The next high demand tactics which are used during the high demand season by the hotels are to evaluate the benefits of sell-throughs. Now, sell-throughs are when there are minimum stay restrictions, but it is ignored or maybe reduced during the high demand, so that guests who want to say book even for a day, or maybe they want to book for higher number of days, can buy the rooms accordingly. Last one is applying deposits and guarantees to the last night of stay. Now, according to the guaranteed reservation, normally only a one day stay, room stay is charged if the guest doesn't show up or if there is a no show in the hotel for a guaranteed reservation. But during high demand seasons, there might be a policy of applying guarantees till the last day of stay, so that there are least chances of cancellations. Okay, so now we move on to the low demand tactics. Low demand tactics are the tactics which are applied during the low demand season of the hotel. First one is selling value and benefits, values and benefits of the hotel to the guests. Whenever a guest comes, we have to focus and sell them the values and benefits of the hotel to the right customer, and we have to give them the best value for their money. Next is offer them packages. Offer the packages to the guests, especially for families or guests who are looking for economic rates. So the packages are a very good deal to attract them, and they are very attracted by two or more products punched in into a single rate. And if the rate is economic and lesser than all the products sold separately, then the guest would surely be attracted. So packages are of course a very good technique which is used during the low demand season. Third one is to keep discount categories open. Now, during high demand season, we are closing or restricting the discounts, whereas in low demand, we are keeping more discount categories open, so that a guest is attracted by the discounts and buys the room for the discounts which are being offered. Now, there is always a saying in the hotel that a room sold is much better than a room which is vacant. So a room which is sold at even at a discount rate is much better than a room which is vacant. So all the discount categories need to be kept open. Next one is encouraging upgrades. If you remember, upgrades are when a guest who has booked for a standard room or a lesser priced room is automatically or is sent or is given a higher priced room with no extra charge, it is known as an upgrade. So upgrades are normally encouraged during low demand seasons, so that the guests feel happy and encouraged to come back again, inspired to come back again and again to the hotel. They feel privileged to be a part of the hotel stay. The next is offering stay sensitive price incentives. Now, stay sensitive price incentives are normally for guests who stay for a longer duration of time. So if a guest wants to stay for more than a week, then the guest might get a special discount or an added discount. So offering stay sensitive prices or price incentives are when a guest stays for a longer duration of time, they get a special price or a special discounts which are applicable to their
स्टे. Next one is removing any stay restrictions. So the rooms, as I already said, any room which is sold is much better than a room which is vacant. So any stay restrictions which are there have to be removed, and if a guest wants a room even for a single day, then it can be sold to the guest. There is no stay restriction for the guest. So if a guest wants it even for a few hours, then the guest can be given that room for the number of hours which the guest wants. Next is involving the staff of the hotel. Now the staff or the people who are working, the employees, are given incentives during, especially during low demand seasons, to encourage higher room sales, and they're given incentives or prizes or awards so that they try to sell the rooms, especially during the low demand seasons. The next is establishing a good relationship with the competitors. Establishing a good relationship with the competitors is very important, so that if there are any referrals or any guests who do not want to stay in their hotel or who want to change their stay, they can be referred by the competitors to your hotel. The last one is lowering rates or keeping the rate, identifying a hurdle rate. Hurdle rate is the lowest applicable rate which can be taken by the hotel, which can be charged by the hotel to a guest. So identifying the hurdle rates, the lowest rates which are acceptable by the hotel to the guest, and then charging accordingly from the guest. Thank you so much. Hello everybody. So the next chapter under the same unit, yield management, is the revenue manager. Now the revenue manager is a person who is responsible for maximizing revenue in a hotel on a daily, monthly and annual basis. So a successful hotel revenue manager should possess the following skills. Operational skills. First one is operational skills. He or she should understand the sources of revenue and the costs for each department, the costs which are required for running each department. He or she should also understand the interdependencies among departments to meet the hotel goals, that is, the coordination of the hotel departments. The second skill which is required by the revenue manager is analytical skills. He or she should understand the historical, current and future revenue data, the data which is related with the revenues. He or she should understand and evaluate hotel booking trends, and he or she should also project occupancy demands. The third skill which a successful revenue manager should possess is strategic skills. Now he or she should understand the market and how it affects the hotel. So market means how the guests are coming, if the guests are coming, the season, if it is a high demand or a low demand season, and so on. He or she should understand the market and how it will affect the hotel accordingly, and he or she should also be able to take advantage of favorable market conditions. So if it is a high demand season, he or she should maximize the revenues by using high demand tactics and in the low demand by using low demand tactics. The next one is organizing skills. He or she should have or should be able to record current operations for future use. So all the current will definitely become history in the coming time. So all the recording has to be done so that these can be used in the future. The next skill which has to be possessed by a successful revenue manager is communication skills. He or she should be able to explain revenue processes and decisions on the business projections. The next skill which needs to be there in a revenue manager, in a good revenue manager, is good listening skill. He or she should be able to listen to team members and other staff and act accordingly, and he or she should also be able to appreciate raised issues and also the suggestions given by the other staff members for maximizing the revenue. The next skill which needs to be required, which needs to be there in a good successful revenue manager, is team building skills. He or she should have ideas and strategies from good working relations. So, the last one is training skills. The revenue manager should be able to train the staff at all levels for successful revenue management. Now we will be going to the job description of the revenue manager. Now, job description normally includes the duties and responsibilities of the revenue manager. So the first duty and responsibility is setting rates, setting the room rates. So first duty is to set rates every night according to the market conditions. Second would be rates should not be too high nor too low according to the market conditions again, and they should be consistent with the competitors. And the goal should be to sell all the rooms at the highest possible rates according to the low demand or high demand seasons. The next duty is forecasting. So he or she should be able to submit forecast revenue reports, has to submit forecast revenue reports. They have to help, he or she should be able to help in business planning of the hotel. The third duty and responsibility is positioning. So he or she has to assist the sales and marketing manager in positioning of the property. Now, what does positioning mean? Positioning means to get guests in the hotel in all the seasons, whether it is a low demand season or a high demand season. So whatever the season is, the revenue manager should be able or has to make sure that there are sales going on in the hotel. The next duty is market area. The revenue manager should be aware of the competitors and the rates which they are offering, and he or she should be using this information to attract revenue to his or her particular property. The last duty and responsibility is managing reservations. He or she also acts as a reservations manager sometimes and hires, trains, disciplines and fires reservations sales staff if required, and also works on employees and motivates employees to bring more revenue to the hotel. Thank you so much.